Thank you, everyone, and thank you all for coming. On a personal note, I just wanted to especially single out Keisha Shepherd for initiating and organizing this. And also Steve, because they worked side by side. But Keisha was the one who came in to the meeting one day and said, "We're doing this, and I'm doing it, and I'm going to lead it." She did a terrific job.
I'm having a hard time hearing you.
I said, Keisha is the one who came into one of our meetings and said, "We're doing this, and I'm going to lead it." And I think she did a terrific job, so I just wanted to thank her personally.
Thank you.
And also all the volunteers, our co-sponsors, our Revolution Howard County, the NAACP Howard County, and the Maryland Progressive Healthcare Coalition. It's so nice to have partners. We felt very alone out here for a long time. We were the only ones who were sort of, it was hard to find other folks to work with, and now it's not hard at all, so that's great. I'm going to do a couple of, do a little selling here. This is our t-shirt. We have a few left. We have about 15 or 20 left, and they're in sizes from medium to double large. So if you want one, just come find me afterwards. And it'll help us out. There's a movie called Fix It, which is a very good film. It's from the business point of view about healthcare. We showed it a lot. And there's a short version and a long version. And I have a lot of these. So anybody who wants to organize a meeting and use the Fix It, or just take it home and read it and watch it themselves, you can actually find it online too. But it's here, and they don't mind you using it all. Richard Masters is the person who put it together. So I'll talk a little bit about our ask for you. We talk a lot about the problems now. I'll go into some of the problems in the healthcare system after this, but there are two bills, one in the House, one in the Senate. They both have the same name, so it's a little confusing. Because there are significant differences. One is in the House, the primary sponsor is Pramila Jayapal. It's H.R. 1384. It's called the Medicare for All, Improved Medicare for All Act of 2019. We like this one better than the other one. The other one is the Bernie Sanders bill in the Senate. That's S-1129. Pramila Jayapal's bill has no co-pays, covers long-term care, has a shorter transition period, a bunch of things. They both end up at the same place, which is a real single-payer system. So, we have a strong preference for the Jayapal bill. There are 8 Maryland congressmen right now. Unfortunately, we're down to 7 because of the recent death of Elijah Cummins, who may have been a victim of the medical system himself. I don't know a lot of details, but he had surgery, and then he was readmitted with an infection, and it just sounded to me like he may have been a victim of the healthcare system. But anyway, so of those 8, we had 4 who were supporters of the Cummins, co-sponsors of single payer. They are Jamie Raskin, Brown, and John Sarbanes, and Elijah Cummins was a supporter, a long-time supporter. We have 4 who haven't, and should be. They're Dutch Rudersberger, David Trones, Steny Hoyer, and Harris. We have a variety of us have been talking to at least the first 3, Rudersberger, Trone, and Hoyer, to try and get them on board. I would urge you to, especially if you're in your district, to contact them and tell them that you want them to support HR 1384. In the Senate, the news is not as good. Neither of our senators, neither Ben Cardin or Chris Van Hollen, has signed on to the Senate bill, the Bernie Sanders Senate bill, which is a good marker for whether you're going to support single payer or not. I guess neither of them were running for president, so maybe that's why they didn't sign on. We had a lot of the people who were signing, who were running for president in the Senate sign on, because it is so popular. What am I doing for time here? They definitely deserve a call or a letter or an email frequently asking them to support single payer, Medicare for all. So that's my pitch as far as the ask. As far as our local Howard County group, we meet the second Tuesdays of the month at the Central Library, so I know all of you are welcome to come to that. How much time do I have left? Okay. So I don't have much time left. So I'm just going to talk a little bit about, you know, the big lie in our, the way our healthcare system is being run is that we use too much care. And everything is sort of centered around that. We use too much care. Everybody's dying to go to the doctor. You know, we all want here wants to go see their doctor all the time. You know? Raise your hand if you want to see a doctor weekly. It would be nice. But, you know. And the result of that is that one of the big factors of that is that people are either uninsured or underinsured, and the number of people who are underinsured is growing. So the result of that has been that we're in a place as far as outcomes where we've never been. And the first evidence of that is life expectancy, which has flatlined in this country for the last 4 years. Never happened. Well, it happened for 3 years at the end of World War I when we had the Spanish flu epidemic. It shouldn't be called the Spanish flu, but we have the influenza epidemic and the effects of World War I. It's not caused by the opioid crisis, although that is a contributing factor. Every major disease group of one has a higher mortality now than it did 4 years ago. We still suffer with high infant mortality and maternal mortality rate that is a disaster. It's embarrassing. One of the slides had this up there, but we have the highest rate among all the wealthy countries of preventable deaths, and that's why we're showing up with a flatlined life expectancy, because people with heart disease, diabetes, respiratory illnesses, the major things that kill people, cancer, they're not going to the doctor on time. They're putting off care. So that's my pitch for today, and I thank you all again for coming. And,